everybody. Debra and Bandit here. You know how when you think you have things under control or you have a plan and then everything just kind of blows up? I often joke that when you have a plan, so I think sometimes God goes, oh, isn't that cute? She has a plan. Well, that happened to me recently over three critical emergency issues, and I shared that during my Friday Night Live. If you were there, you saw it, or if you've seen it since then, you know what I'm talking about. It wasn't exactly my finest hour, but as my friends David and Jay always say, love came running. And I'm going to share with you today the three critical emergencies and what has happened since my Friday Night Live. Stay tuned. First of all, I'm humbled by the outpouring of love and support that I've received since my, after my breakdown during my Friday Night Live. And please stay with me through this update and I'll let you know exactly what I'm going to do with the funds and what those are going to be used for. The three critical emergencies that I faced recently were 1, transportation until my RV is road worthy and dependable. 2, repairs to the RV to be made that I thought I were already made. And 3, repairs and modifications to my rooftop AC that had already been paid for and made. Now mind you, I've already sunk about $6,000 into Freebird, my new to me RV, to get the working AC units in her, both the rooftop and the engine, and as well as repairs and modifications to get her road ready. In fact, I took out 2 loans to make that happen, as well as set up my home base. And right now, I want to address 2 kind of important side notes. 1, just because I'm setting up a home base doesn't mean I'm not going to travel anymore. In fact, quite the opposite. A home base to me is just that, a base from which to operate and come back to in between my travels. And a place to call home when crazy things like a global pandemic happen. But I'm still going to be on the road as soon as it is safe for me and for you and my RV. Also, I will address the alternative AC options that people have suggested, and I appreciate that. But I'm going to address that this coming Friday in my Friday Night Live, so be sure and stay tuned for that. Speaking of my FNL, my Friday Night Live, if you want details on where I kind of lost it and cried, you can click on the full video here and go to that video. You can even fast forward on the timeline that is listed in the video description and the pinned comment if you want to just go to that part. On that FNL, the Friday Night Live, I shared that for the past 2 weeks that I had been in town to get all of those repairs done, both AC units, the house and the engine, and I ended up having to be towed back to my mechanics even after all of that, and I didn't even make it out of town. And again, that's on the FNL, and you can go watch that. But anyway, I barely made it home on Friday. I gimped along and I got home just in time for the FNL, and it made for a dreadful weekend. To be honest, I spent a lot more time over the weekend continuing to cry, and I also reached out to my close friends and family, and I also spent a lot of time in prayer and meditation. It's also important to me that, you know, I thought I had the situation under control because I went with repair people that I had been referred to, that had been recommended to me, and I didn't do the homework that I should have because of those recommendations. And all I can say to you is that if someone out there gives you a referral, even then, be sure to check it out. Some examples: are they a member of the BBB? Are they a member of the local Chamber of Commerce or something similar? Do they have the required state licenses as a business? Do they have the local requirements and licenses as a business, county or city, if those are required? What are their ratings on Yelp, Google, LinkedIn, Facebook, all of those things? And lastly, if you need to still get further reassurance, call 2 or 3 of their previous customers. If they're a legitimate business, they should be willing to let you do that. And like I said, I didn't do any of that because I trusted the recommendations I received. And now here I sit, barely making it home in an RV that I can't drive, trust to drive across the street, let alone get into town and forget about her being ready to be on the road for travel. So that is why I was crying Friday night, and that's why I had such a hard time over the weekend, because there's a lot of ramifications from that. But love came running, like I said in the intro. One more thing that I want you to know that I think is extremely important is, one, Robert stayed for almost a month longer than he intended to, because he wanted to make sure that the RV was as near ready as possible and that I would be safe. And two, by the time he left, we had those people lined up. We thought we had a mechanic and we had an RV tech lined up. And it's unfortunate that didn't work out well, but we didn't know that at the time. And Robert stayed until the last minute before he had to leave to go out of town to meet with a client for work. And as of Friday, the rig was in worse shape than when he left. But at the time, neither one of us had had any way of knowing that all of that would happen. And this has been very hard on him. He checks in on me multiple times a day. And so for those of you that are wondering, where is Robert in all of this? He's right here. Okay, critical emergency number one, the rooftop AC. Obviously, the recommendation that I made on the previous AC installation video has been removed. It wasn't installed properly and it had issues from day one, not to mention some other things. But I stayed after the contractor with phone calls, emails, and text. And the owner, he never got back to me until Saturday, you guys. I almost dropped the phone when he finally answered. And then he and Jim, the tech that works for him, who I still trust, I enjoy Jim's professionalism. And anyway, they showed up yesterday, Monday, and they did quite a lot of work and repair on the AC unit. And so far, it is working great. They cut the wood to properly install it up against the ceiling, as mounted as it should have been to start with. They did some ductwork repair that took quite a while, and they rerouted the power supply, the big cord that comes from the unit to the power supply. And I'm not sure what all that entailed, but I'm so grateful to finally have a rooftop AC unit that so far today, 2 days later, seems like it's still working. And especially since it was paid for in full and it took me a while to get a response back, at least for now, Bandit and I are once again safe and cool in Freebird. The second thing was repairs that need to be made to Freebird in order to get her road ready. I spent all of my money on the repairs that I've already talked about, and out of the two loans that I mentioned, I did buy a shed to set up a home base, and I bought like a $100 grill. Other than that, everything, every dime has gone into Fancy Free, and the entire wad, as a matter of fact. And so to get her drivable again, that meant I was not looking at being able to get the AC repaired, which meant no cabin AC. I always say I have the best viewers in the world, and I mean it. Your generous support from Friday night made it possible for me to move forward in at least getting the repairs done to the engine so that I can make sure that she is road ready. And thank you all so very much. Part of my tears and angst throughout the weekend was facing the reality of having to be in Freebird in this triple digit weather without cabin AC, driving her. Even in the mornings, it can get up to 100 by 10 o'clock. And plus fearing that she might break down again on the side of the road with minimal repairs done. And this record-breaking heat in the Mojave Desert in the middle of the summer, that could truly be life or death for me or Bandit. And like I said, love came running. A Patreon and friend has said she is going to gift me the cabin, the engine AC. That means that I will be able to use the gifted donations from my wonderful viewers on the Friday Night Live to pay for the engine repairs. I don't know what happened when everything blew up underneath the hood. Again, go to the Friday Night Live video if you want those details. But there's more good news. After all that happened, Robert researched mechanics for anywhere in this area, and he contacted a new mechanic over the weekend that is apparently regarded as skilled and professional and just well known. and their ratings are high, and so they have all the checkbox marked. Check. They called Robert back yesterday, so he called and left them a message on Saturday. They called him back on yesterday, Monday, and he felt comfortable enough with them after kind of an interview that we set up an appointment for them to come out next week, and they will take a look at what needs to be done with Freebird. They're more costly, but they are bonded and a legitimate business, so it's going to be worth it, you guys. They get all of their parts locally, and the parts and work will be warranted. They also promise that if they do run across something that they can't take care of, that they will help me find someone that can. They won't just leave me in the lurch and high and dry. And I just really am hopeful and have enjoyed talking with them, and we'll see how it goes. I'm so blessed and so relieved. Thank you all, and thank you, Robert, for helping me find them, and thank you to my patron and friend for offering the gift of AC so that I can get the other repairs done and have both, and fingers crossed that it'll all finally happen. And I'll talk more about that in a minute. Number three, the critical issue was transportation until Freebird is road ready. And again, I don't mean just travel, I mean able to go into town. I can't risk getting stranded in the desert. No one should have to, but for me, it truly could cost me my life in a matter of minutes, and let alone any additional time, like an hour or so being stranded on the road in this heat. And like I said on my Friday Night Live, I've got doctor's appointments coming up. My new doctor wants MRIs, a head CAT scan, and she wants to see me at least every other week until we figure some things out. And I was going to have to cancel on all of that, not to mention the concern of how I was going to get groceries and take care of Bandit and everything. And once again, love came running in the form of several wonderful viewers in the area offered to take me back and forth. But you guys, you know that's a lot, especially since I'm so far out. It felt great to have the offers. And again, I'm humbled. I'm truly humbled by the generosity of strangers. And it's stressful to impose on others and to rely on that. So love came running in yet another form. And I'm beyond blown away to be able to tell you that my friend Lynn has made arrangements to loan me a car until Freebird is 100% road ready. Blown away. Also, I got to tell you, I know that God is my ultimate source, and that is true for everybody worldwide. But he often shows up in the form of earth angels. And so again, thank you all. So in closing, I just want to remind you that I had three critical emergencies on Friday. I was needing transportation until Freebird was roadworthy, and I was needing to make additional or more or repeat repairs on Freebird so that I could even be able to drive her, and I needed my rooftop AC repaired because it wasn't working and it was close to 100 degrees in here at all times. And within 72 hours, I have hope of all of that turning around, and the AC seems like it is already working. After my Friday Night Live, I had several people tell me to quit crying, you know, pull myself together. Basically, what they were saying are those old adages of tighten your belt and put your big girl britches on, and I just hate those sayings, and I honestly think that they're ridiculous. While I wish I had not lost it in front of the World Wide Web, I want to also stress for anybody watching this that there is nothing wrong with feeling the fear and moving forward in faith. I tried my best during the Friday Night Live to say that I was having a hard time, but I still wholeheartedly believe in and still do my motto, COCO, keep on keeping on. So many times in our life, God doesn't illuminate but one rung of the ladder at a time. Sometimes it seems not even that. And I'm reminded of another old adage that says it's always darkest before the dawn, and the sun always rises. And I know we all know this, but sometimes it's so hard to remember. And I said Friday night that I knew things would eventually change and things would work out one way or the other. They always do. And that's part of my tattoo here, the yin and the yang. Everything is temporary and everything has its opposite side. We just have to hang on. But you know, I sure wasn't looking forward to a hard summer of hardship in the Mojave Desert. I was getting depressed, and I think Bandit was too. But then love came running. And that's another part of my tattoo. Love never fails. Of course, the yin and the yang I just talked about. Hold everyone in their brightest light always, no matter what. And infinity. Nothing ever goes away, and nothing or no one ever goes away. So I guess I just want to say again, also, before I close completely, and thank y'all for listening and being here on this channel with me, and I'm going to get back to regular programming soon, but I want to say again that I wouldn't be able to do any of this if it weren't for my friends Jeff and Gina, and they had given me such a good deal on Freebird. For all of us, God always shows up in love and light if we just look for it, and if we'll just look at also each microscopic moment, that minute by minute, not just hour by hour or day by day. Sometimes it boils down to the exact moment that we're in, and we can look at that usually and see that all our needs are met. We can faith it even when we can't see it. Over the weekend, I had to remind myself that my doctors didn't even think I would see 2016, and that I've lost everything before, and if I lost everything again, I would survive, and including the ability to drive. I wasn't able to do that for over a year. I had to do the disability van and rely on family and friends then. So this weekend I just kept praying and meditating and telling God that I knew I was in good hands, but it sure would be good if he could show me a sign and some evidence of that. And then, like I said, love came running. So my wonderful viewers, my family and friends, and my patrons that might be watching this, my Coco fam, if you're in the middle or in the throngs of something, please remember to not give up. Keep on keeping on, no matter what. And I want to know, how do you cope with life's darkest moments? Please share in the comments below. Thanks, everyone. And in case no one has told you today, please know that you are loved beyond belief. See you down the road, everybody. Bye.